Welcome to a new tutorial of cloth dynamics, and today we're going to make a new dress for Margot here. In this case we're just disabling all the stuff we don't need right now, and we can also here automatic setting. I already turned off all the bones and usual stuff that might annoy us when we're making the clothes. Okay, so we start with a Bezier spline. The spline will be created at 000, so I'm moving it here now that we can see it. So that will be the front part of the dress we're going to make. And it's very simple. But also it's a bit limited, so you can't really, it's not really comparable with Marvelous Design or some other tool that's more has more features than this one. I mean, basically it's the same, but this has less features. So for example, if we want to move more than one point together, we only have to use the transform part, and it's also a bit annoying, but yeah, that's some small stuff that I like to fix in the future. So this is already quite good, and now to this side, just trying to get more to the shape of the character. Okay, so now we can add points. Really doesn't matter when we want to or where we add them. We just press Control D, and then we duplicate one point, and we can move it around. We can now adjust our structure, or we can just leave the point there where we want it. For example, we want it here at the waist, somewhere there, and then we have to move it up. So the hierarchy will tell us where the how the spline is constructed, and then we can of course create another point like this, and it might need to get here. Okay, so that's how it works here. Okay. Then what else do we need? We need two points here. Of course, just one here, and another one. So, and somewhere here they are here. Okay. Almost. Yeah, like this. Okay, that's a bit complicated to edit, but I think we can get used to it because it's not so slow. You can create cloth quite easily with this simple cloth like this, but there are limits again. But we come to that later. Okay, so for this simple case, where we just add, yeah, just duplicate these two points. As you can see, I can only move this one and both. If I want to move both, I have to go in here again, move these here. Okay, and I think there we'll need to go somewhere here, yeah. Okay. So let's just move this guy here and then one here. So okay. And maybe around the hips here there should be also some more points. We'll use these. And yeah, just move move the mouse up right here, and yeah, I think this guy has to go here, another one here, so like this. Alright. Alright. Then, yeah, currently we're just playing around with the splines, and now we will create the garment. And what this will do is using the points and creating a mesh structure. And at first very low poly, but that's good because it's easier to edit it when you want to get more high res, then it will also slow down. And what the special thing is now, when we want to move a point, we can still move it like this, but we can't move it in the Z or C direction. As you can see, only the controls of the Bezier will move, but not the point. And that's intended because the generation of the mesh structure is limited to a plane, so we are now working on a plane. Okay, and what we also can do is we can use Bezier curves. For example, here in this area, it would be nice. So we can, of course, we can start, and we have to turn off always here. Then we can start and move these curves, and yeah, as you can see, now getting round shapes. But this feature might not always be a good idea because there can be some problems with the mesh generation. So yeah, maybe we just leave it like this, and then we of course we have to set this on, and when of course we have to also update the resolution, and then it should work. Yeah, I think it's already, yeah, it's following the Bezier curve. And when I turn this off, as you can see, then it just ignores the curve. So that's for the Bezier stuff. And I forgot something. We just need some more points here. One more point. Where are you? Yeah. Oh, that's this one. I think that's right. Then yeah, we have to not the line. Make it straight. Ah, but no, that's why I normally just do the Bezier stuff in the end. Just now for now, move them up like this. Okay. I think there's some function how you can adjust the handle, but for now I think it's okay. We just do it manually. So we need this point also on the other side. Here. And so we move them here. And find the missing order, right order. I think we must go with this side. Oh yeah, and now they are totally upside down. better when you use a knight, yeah, of course. The same as for this is a knight, of course, better. Mirrored. Yeah, mirrored. Okay. I think that's fine for now. And maybe we should also move them a bit outside. If it's possible. This will always break the spines up here. I mean, for now it's okay. I can just go in there and edit this. But of course, it would be nicer to keep it. But yeah, this is just a demonstration, doesn't need to be perfect. So, okay, let's go with this. So, we're now having our first part here. And then, yeah, we can create the other side by just duplicating it and moving it backwards. This is better than rotating, because when we connect these edges together, they might flip when we also rotate the spline. So it's better when we not rotate it. We just keep it like this, and we select the flip normal. As you can see, the blue line here shows the normal, and so the mesh will. The normals will face in this direction. And that's it, yeah. Then now we can start connecting this. So we start using this, our main spline dress, I will call it. Because that will be also the name of the mesh later. And then we lock it, the inspector, that's important. So we're locking it here, and now we can select all these edges. And then we can press connect edge, and it will automatically connect these edges for us. And we can just select them, pressing shift and select two points actually. I'm just selecting the points, and here again, as you can see, normally they are the same objects because I duplicated them. And this one, when it's 7, must be 7 there. So connect this and this one and this one. So we're almost there. Only one point inside this one. So now we've got it. Okay. Yeah, we might don't want this here in the back, so we can just now go in here and move these points here maybe up a bit. And also we can just oh, this was the wrong. I'm still on this object here, so I have to unlock the inspector, and then now I can go in here and update this values, and then I can also remove the bezier on this one. The curve settings, I mean. So, okay, now I think everything is fine. And when we can start connecting these two splines, just checking the normals again, this one, this side, this one, this. Then we press create mesh from splines, and then we can just hide our splines for a second, and we see this is now the mesh. This is how it looks, and yeah, let's try this. I mean, we can always go back and modify this and create another mesh or override the old mesh and can play with these values. And so now just add the cloth dynamics object here.